now to alpine skiing and the second leg of the women's super combined. A slalom run down the Universiade piste, cloudy conditions greeting the skiers as they attempted to negotiate the 51 turns ahead of them. Sakuraku Mukogawa of Japan was 26th after the first run, over 2.5 seconds behind the leader. She didn't even finish the Super G on Friday, looking much better in the slalom segment. She would finish with the fastest slalom time of all, 46.18 seconds, easily into first place at that moment. Oyana Gantnerova of Slovakia, 22nd after the first run, just under half a second faster than Mukogawa. She was 21st in Friday's Super G competition, also looking much better in the more technical discipline, 46.36 seconds. That would be the third fastest slalom run and put her ahead of Mukogawa and into first place for the moment. What Yulia Bayalo of Spain, just 19 years of age, 20th on the first run, over 2 seconds off the lead. 22nd in the Super G on Friday. Another one looking much more at home on the shorter skis. Good attack here, very smooth. Good through the transition as well, and she would finish with 46.64 seconds. That's the seventh fastest of the slalom times, but 0.21 behind Gantnerova and into second place. Well, Maren Byrkjeland of Norway, 16th on the first run. About a third of a second in hand over Gantnerova. Eighth in the Super G on Friday. Not really happy with her first run in the combined. Much happier in the slalom though. Recovering from that mistake well to record a 46.35 seconds, the second fastest of all the competitors down the slalom, putting her into first pace by nearly half a second. Victoria Martel-Stevens of Canada from the University of Montreal was 15th off the first run. She only had 0.06 of a second in hand over Bjorklund. 16th in the Super G. Putting in another solid run here, 12th fastest in fact from the slalom, 47.5 seconds, but only good enough for 5th place at that point. And only going to drop further down the standings. Well, Kristin Fausser-Arsberg of Norway, 12th after the first run, gold medalist in the Super G on Friday. One of the favourites for a medal here. A 20-year-old really attacking the slalom part of this competition. Great balance and poise. Attacking well. Much faster after a disappointing Super G. 46.62, sixth in the slalom. Only second for the moment. A chance, though, of another medal. Just 0.01 of a second behind a compatriot, Paula Klicnarova of the Czech Republic, fifth after the first run. In a very strong position for a medal. She was fourth in the downhill and 10th in the Super G in the 2013 Universiade in Trentino, 13th in the Super G on Friday as well. Getting a bit twisted there. Plenty of time in hand though, 47.27. Enough to put her into first place by 0.15 of a second ahead of Bjorklund. Well, Daria Ovchinnikova of Russia, just 19 years of age, third after the first run. Seventh in the Super G on Friday. Again, looking very balanced through the middle of the run. Not the tidiest though, but 47.31, enough to put her into the lead, 0.26 ahead of Klicnarova. Now then, Maria Bedarova of Russia, 22-year-old, second after the first run, fifth in the Super G on Friday. A real speed merchant though, and you can see that here. Not so comfortable in the technical discipline, scrubbing off too much speed through these turns, not keeping her momentum. Just lacking a little bit of the technique as well of some of her competitors. 17th fastest, in fact, in the slalom. Obviously not her forte. And she would end up in a share of 9th place. Well, Karina Chrapek of Poland, a big favourite, leader after the first run. Silver medal in Friday's Super G to go with her silver from the Super G from 2 years ago in Trentino, and a bronze in a downhill as well in Italy. Hot favourite, but missing a gate. Absolute disaster for the 25-year-old. The hot favourite out. Daria Ovchinnikova of Russia takes the gold ahead of Klicnarova and Byrkjeland.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.